This is a textbook description of how the rice should be cooked. It takes skill and years and decades of perseverance and dedication to a craft to be able to cook a biryani like this.
It's no secret that Hyderabad loves its biryani, but the one biryani that rules everyone's palate is a biryani here at BAWARCHI. And not just any BAWARCHI, but the BAWARCHI here at RTC Cross Road. That's the Hyderabadi biryani that people craze for. And that's where we are here today to explore the taste of that authentic, special Hyderabadi biryani. So let's go and find out what makes it special.
Hello. I'm the owner of this restaurant.
Oh, nice to meet you. What's your name?
Abbas.
Abbas. Nice to meet you. Hello. Nice to meet you too.
Thank you so much for coming.
Thank you very much, you know, having us over and for opening your doors to us.
It's a pleasure.
Thank you. So I want to ask you this one question. What makes that BAWARCHI biryani so special?
Our hard work and our quantity of rice which we are giving, our quality of biryani, that makes our biryani so special.
Alright, and it's just begun to rain here, and they say when it rains it's always an auspicious start.
Yes.
And that's the start that we've made. How did it begin? How did BAWARCHI biryani?
In the year 1994 we started our restaurant.
Okay.
The original BAWARCHI.
The original BAWARCHI.
Yes.
So this is where it began 25 years ago, yes. The same location.
Same location.
Alright. And yeah, you've expanded also to this, for the AC section.
Yes.
So when we asked Hyderabad and they said biryani at BAWARCHI, and then when we came to Hyderabad we see many BAWARCHIs which are not
that
the
is
BAWARCHI.
All fake. This is the original BAWARCHI at RTC Cross Road. This is the original one. We are the founders of BAWARCHI restaurant.
So in a manner, you know, they say imitation is a form of flattery.
Yeah, they have taken our name and they are running their own business.
So I am happy that we are here at the BAWARCHI. The BAWARCHI that, in a manner of speaking, put the Hyderabadi biryani on the map. And we're going to not just taste the biryani, but also explore how the iconic
biryani is made.
Biryani is made. I can already smell that smoky aroma of the biryani in the air.
This is chicken biryani.
This is chicken biryani.
Yes. This is mutton biryani.
This is the mutton biryani.
This is veg biryani.
Oh, the veg biryani.
Yes.
So do you have a lot of people coming in for the veg biryani?
No, we have
no. Oh, okay.
So we have fish biryani also.
We have fish biryani, yes. As well.
Chicken biryani and mutton biryani. We are famous for these both.
For these both.
Yes.
All right. So इसमें कितना किलोमीटर होगा?
चार
किलोमीटर. और ये चार किलोमीटर मतलब कितने portions होंगे?
25
portions. और ये सारे spices जाते हैं इसमें. अच्छा, curd जाता है आपके biryani में?
हाँ, ये main thing.
It's the main thing. तो मैरिनेशन में होता है कि
फॉर द मैरिनेशन.
सो वी हैव गॉट ऑल द इंग्रेडिएंट्स हियर फॉर दिस लवली मटन दैट्स गोइंग टू बी कुक्ड इनटू अ बिरयानी. सो देयर सम कार्डमम एंड शाजीरा दैट हैज गॉन इनटू इट, सम सिनेमन एज वेल, द सॉल्ट दैट इज गोइंग इन, द रेड चिली, द जिंजर गार्लिक पेस्ट, द ग्रीन चिली. बस ग्रीन चिली है इसमें.
कोरिएंडर.
वंडरफुल. हाँ, ये ब्रिस्ता. डीप फ्राइड अनियन. द ब्रिस्ता. आई थिंक दिस ब्रिस्ता गिव्स इट दैट डीप फ्लेवर. सो सम पपाया आल्सो दैट गोज दैट हेल्प्स टू टेंडराइज द मीट. नो दैट हेल्प्स टू मेक इट नाइस एंड जूसी एंड सॉफ्ट. सो देयर्स अ लॉट ऑफ ब्रिस्ता दैट गोज इनटू इट. आई थिंक दैट गिव्स इट दैट flavor.
Yeah. And the brishta, when we put it, it become like a gravy, what we say, masala.
The masala.
Yeah.
So the brown basically is from that brishta.
Brishta and dahi.
And the dahi.
So
वो मिलजुल
कर
वो मसाला बनता है बिरयानी का. Wonderful. So there you go. All those fresh ingredients that have gone into it are now being mixed. That All that is being massaged into the meat nicely.
Yeah.
You can see that the color has changed completely. It's a reddish brown now with that chili powder with the brishta. Oh, look at all that curd. मतलब ये ज़्यादा गाढ़ा नहीं है दही जो डालता है इसमें. The oil. You can see that masala of that Hyderabadi biryani taking shape here. So the meat that's gone into it, it's of a goat that is only 7 to 8 kilos because that ensures that the meat is tender and juicy. Isme hot water daloge aap, acha. So they put the hot water into that meat after it's mixed into all that marinade. And apparently that helps when they bring in the rice which is half cooked. And now they've added some salt into the water here and shajira, some coriander as well, some cinnamon and some cloves. And next they will add the rice into this. So there's 8 kilos of basmati rice that has gone in for 4 kilos of meat. Fantastic. And this will feed about 25 people. So I think because of the spices that have gone into the water in which the rice is going to be cooked, I think the rice will also get some of that flavor. It's one big family that's involved in the entire...
Yeah, almost all of them.
Yeah?
Any work they have, everybody knows all of the things.
Everybody knows everything?
Yeah.
Ah, okay.
So they go and look after everything.
So can you guys make the biryani?
Yes.
The BAWARCHI biryani. Excellent. So the rice has come to the first boil. So he's going to take some of that rice, strain it, and that's the first layer that's going on the meat. This is the making of a traditional Hyderabadi biryani. After the first layer is put, after a minute, he takes another portion of the rice and layers it on that again. So the idea is that the rice that's closest to the bottom will cook more, and the rice that's furthest away from the bottom is a rice that doesn't need to cook as much. And that's the whole principle of the layering of the rice on top of the meat. So this is the third layer of the rice, and you can see that the rice is progressively getting cooked a little more, as he takes it and ladles it on to the meat. I like the way he sprinkles the rice evenly all over the meat. It shows a certain skill. Of course, he's been making the biryani here for the last 5 years, but the family has this tradition of making this biryani for the last quarter of a century, 25 years. And this is the fourth layer of the rice that's going on top of the biryani. Now it's just a matter of taking all the remaining rice and ladling it on top of the meat. There is some coloring that is going on the rice. This is what gives it that yellow color. So that's it. So this pot is going to go onto the fire, and in half an hour we'll have a delicious pot of steaming hot Hyderabadi mutton biryani. I can smell the gentle aromas of the biryani waft to the surface. I'm looking forward to tasting this biryani. You can see the color of that masala that's risen through that biryani. So as the biryani is getting cooked, I think all those aromas, all that vapor rises up, and along with it carries the masala.
Yeah.
Oh, wonderful. I can't wait to taste this biryani. You know, I'm tasting the legendary Hyderabadi biryani at the legendary BAWARCHI. And I'm tasting this biryani fresh off the pot. I don't think I could have asked for anything better. It's hot to the touch, but I'm so greedy that I can't wait to go in right now. You know, this light smokiness to this biryani. You can taste the masala, but the masala makes its presence felt in a very gentle sort of a fashion.
Yeah.
It's not the sort of masala that will jolt your senses. It's the sort of masala that will lull your senses, that will comfort your senses. And that's what I taste in this Bawarchi Biryani. As you can see, that meat, all the spices, all that, all the masala, the curd, the chili, the herbs, all of that has been massaged into this meat. And this meat has been cooking, allowing for the flavors, drawing from the flavors of the marinade, drawing from the flavors of the spices, the herbs. That piece of meat is juicy, is tender, with the least amount of bite. It just kind of has trapped all that masala, and as you bite into it, it gives up, it releases all those beautiful flavors into your mouth. I will eat this outside in the restaurant. The taste of this biryani is absolutely incredible. It's as tasty as that. Thank you, chef. Bahut badhiya hai. So we've just watched the biryani being prepared here at Bawarchi, and now I'm sitting with the family members and we're going to taste some of that biryani that we just watched being prepared. Of course, we watched the mutton biryani being prepared, but we will also make a beginning with the chicken biryani. So I can't wait to get my biryani meal going here at Bawarchi. So this is the raita.
Yeah, that's the raita. The and this is the sherva.
So ye kaise banta hai ye? With the
til, haldi,
the sesame paste. So the biryanis have also arrived. We've tasted a bit of that mutton biryani just off the pot. We're now going to taste the chicken biryani. You can see that steam emanate from this biryani even as it's being served. It's as hot as that. And I'm told, given the popularity of this place, the biryani never has an opportunity to get cold because it's over even before that. And I can see that steaming plate of biryani. So the chicken biryani is on the plate. Time to begin.
Yeah, sure.
Bismillah. It's got this very gentle aroma. It's not a sort of biryani whose aroma will fill the room, but it's got this very gentle, very alluring sort of aroma. You know, the masala, I find, has really gone into every grain of the rice. You can see that that masala has gone all the way in to this piece of meat. You know, what I really love is the fact that this biryani is so flavorful and that masala has uniformly spread. I think that's what makes you want to go back to this biryani bite after bite, right? So what is your favorite biryani?
Mutton biryani.
Mutton biryani.
Mutton biryani.
Mutton.
Mutton biryani.
What about you?
Both.
Both, Asha. You know, I think mutton biryani always has more flavor.
Yeah.
I think the chicken, the poor chicken is at a disadvantage because the mutton itself has so much flavor. So I think for a chicken dish to really rise, it has to do that much more work. Right? So I personally am more partial to a mutton biryani. But a chicken biryani like this, I'll certainly come back for a second helping. As you can see, every grain of this chicken biryani here is coated in that masala, thereby making for that flavorful bite. You know, typically when you're thinking of Hyderabadi food, sometimes you have this perception that the flavors are over the top. But this is none of that. The flavors here are mellow, the flavors here are gentle. It's a sort of masala that begs you to come back and taste it bite after bite. That's what this chicken biryani is all about. I have to taste this biryani now with some sherva. And this is basically made from sesame paste. So is it red chili powder or is it?
Powder.
Red chili powder. And what are these? Is this some?
Zira rye.
Zira rye, okay. Curry patta. I'll taste this first just by itself. So you certainly taste that, the weight that comes from the sesame. And then there's a slight khattapan hai isme, thoda bahut. I think that sherva provides for some relief in between mouthfuls of the chicken biryani. So I'm going to
taste this with the sherva and the sherva containing this curry leaf. My favorite biryani any day is a mutton biryani, and I can say that with all due apology to all the chicken lovers out there, but this chicken biryani I can go back to as many times as you'd care to feed me. It's as delicious, as tasty, and as flavorful as that. You know, this piece of meat, it's mildly pink inside. It soaked all the flavors of the masala. As the masala, as the spices are massaged into the meat, it soaks it up. And when you heat it, when you put it on the fire 30 minutes later, all those flavors intensify, helping enhance the flavor of the meat. It's a tough act to flavor chicken, but this one is beautifully flavored. It's the sort of chicken that you want to go back to. Now that we've tasted the chicken biryani, it's time to taste the mutton biryani. We watch this biryani being cooked from scratch, from the meat to the meat being gently massaged with all those spices and then being layered with the rice before finally being cooked. And that's the biryani that's right here on our table. I've already tasted this biryani in the kitchen, but I can't wait to taste this again. Fursat mein, aram se. Thank you. It feels warm and comforting to the touch. You know, when I taste this biryani, beyond all the adjectives that I can use to describe the taste of this biryani makes me feel happy inside. You haven't realized up until this point that you've been missing this taste, but you taste it and then you realize what you've been missing. I think that's the flavor that I taste in this biryani. It's as comforting, it's as reassuring, and it's as tasty as that. This is a textbook description of how the rice should be cooked. Each grain of rice is fluffy, it's separate, it's not clumped together, and it's just a happy coming together of the rice and the spices and the flavor from the meat, making for one supremely delicious mouthful. Rice itself feels complete in all aspects. So that meat you're not really missing, because all that flavor of the meat is trapped in the rice. As the meat cooks, it gives up its flavors in the form of the steam that rises from that meat marinated in all the masala, and that steam as it rises finds its way and impregnates the rice with all that flavor. And I think that's what this biryani is all about. But now we will taste the meat too. That piece of meat has the gentlest of bites. I think meat needs to have a bit of bite, because after all, that's the way it asserts its personality in its texture. So you need to have that bit of a bite that comes from the meat. And this meat has that gentlest, that most delicate of bite with all that flavor. And you can see that meat is pink inside. It's as tender as that. It takes skill and years and decades of perseverance and dedication to a craft to be able to cook a biryani like this. This biryani, truth be told, needs little else. But we have some raita here. We're going to taste it with the raita too. So in a manner of speaking, when you're tasting this biryani with that raita, it's once again coming a full circle from the yogurt that's gone into the meat along with the brista to that raita that you find served to you in a bowl on the table. To me, that raita just provides that relief. If you by any chance believe you have too much, or you have too much of a good thing going and you want to kind of provide some relief to your palate and taste something slightly different, thoda sa khatta, so go to the raita, thoda kha lo, refresh your palate, and then dive back into the biryani, because that's what it's all about here at BAWARCHI. having tasted the biryani, having watched the biryani being cooked, and sitting here on this table with the family that runs BAWARCHI, I can only say this one thing, that you haven't tasted Hyderabadi biryani until you've tasted the biryani at BAWARCHI on RTC Cross Road. So make sure when you're next in Hyderabad to take some time to make a visit to BAWARCHI at RTC Cross Road and savor a delicious morsel of Hyderabad's rich culinary legacy. Until the next episode of Gourmet on the Road, stay safe and happy eating. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe, share and leave a comment. If you'd like to support Food Lovers TV, do log on to foodlovers.in and hit the Support Food Lovers banner. Links in the description below. Happy eating!